Hello again. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, for another walk. We're back in Ealing Broadway for this one. Now, we have done this in a couple of previous videos, so we're back again. It's quite a busy Sunday by the look of it, so I thought we'd have a look around the shops to see if there's anything interesting to see. Currently mid-March, first signs of spring. It's dry and it's quite mild, around 14 degrees centigrade. It has been a very cold start to March, but it seems to have slightly warmed up a little bit. So, green man, so we'll make a quick dash. As I say, we're currently in the Broadway. We're just going to make a little walk down. I'll have a look through the shopping centre a bit. See if there's anything here. There's the famous horse there that people used to come out of the pubs and try and mount the horse. More often than not, they'd fall over the other side and do themselves an injury. But yeah, flowers, if that's what you're interested in. Very busy today, as it is Mother's Day. Looking pretty busy, as you would expect, Sunday afternoon. Used to be a day of rest, but not anymore. Flying Tiger. I've seen a couple of these shops, not sure what they do. Saviour's Walk, we'll have a look down here, not sure what's here. I have walked it many times, but I can't remember. The Ealing Club, Rolling Stones. Well, there's a history of the Ealing Jazz Club, which was under the station there. I used to frequent the place myself, but that was more in the 80s, what it was called. I can't remember it now. Maddox. That was the name of it, Maddox. And then after that it was Club Azure. But it got a lot of history. Anyway, we're just in the main shopping centre here. Thank you. Mummers looks busy, as it always does. Wagamamas in Turtle Bay. It's busy. I do like Turtle Bay. In fact, I'll be going there later for something to eat for a birthday. But not just yet, because I'm a bit early. Anyway, that's later on. Yes. Just going to carry on having a little walk around. Good to see it so busy though, but then again Ealing Broadway always was. Always plenty going on, busy pubs. We've got the busy Questors Theatre over there. A little osteria. I've never been in this place, but I have to say I like the look of it. No one's sitting outside though, funny enough. It's still a bit chilly, like I say, it's about 13 or 14 degrees, which is quite pleasant for walking about. But it's not t-shirt weather yet. But then again, it is only mid-March, so to be expected. Busy, busy, busy. Lots of people on their phones. In fact, everyone's on their phones. Anyway, I like it when there's a lot of people out and about.
There was, I'm very glad.
Getting a friendly nod or two is always good. Just outside the Grove pub. Formerly the Queen Vic, as I remember it. Well, a quick look in there actually. Must be a good roast in there. There's plenty of people eating it. I'm just going to take a walk down towards South Ealing. Now, I have covered Ealing in previous walks, but not as far as South Ealing, so I'll have a look down there. I've done Norfields previously. Notice a little blue plaque on the wall over there, Ealing Studios. I'm not sure who it is, so I'm going to cross over and have a look. Can't walk past the blue plaque. It just wouldn't be right. Cutting across the muddy grass, but there we go. Sir Malcolm Balcon, film producer, worked here 1938 to 1956. I think we can zoom in on that. Sir Michael Balcon, and there is a pub named after him as well. I think it's a Wetherspoons pub, up towards sort of Ealing Common. Not sure what films he made. Someone will know. You can drop it in the comments below, or I can look it up. Anyway, onwards. Red Lion. Down there. hear the little birds chirping away there, so it's definitely beginning to feel like spring, which is good. Just sort of stop there for a minute, get your bearings, just outside the castle pub, the castle inn. So, currently walking down St Mary's Road. We've got St Mary's Church up there. Not up there, but further down here. So, it's starting to get more al fresco now. The weather's, well, not warming up, but less cold, more people sitting outside. So we've got the Castle Inn and the New Inn, both very popular in South Ealing. Mother's Day meals. Just realised that's probably why they're so popular. So we've got St Mary's there, wonderful old church. Fine example of architecture and brickwork. I do like decorative brickwork, as you probably know from previous videos. But it always impresses me how skillful they were back in the day. Guys, letting me go. Nice of him. So is this one. Cheers. Right, there's another little pub tucked away here. Rose and Crown. We'll have a look at the church entrance first. That's a very imposing building. Wonderful architecture. Not sure if there is a date anywhere on the church. I'd say it's an original site but been rebuilt maybe. I'm not sure. See if we can find a stone inscription. I mean, I could look it up obviously and find out. But as with most of the walks I do, I never really plan them. I kind of have a rough idea where I'm going and then I'll just kind of let it sort of take me wherever I want to go. Nowhere in particular. So I could look it up and do more research before coming, but sometimes spontaneity is the way, rather than planning it, because if it doesn't go according to plan, then you get a bit frustrated. But if you just go for a wander, which is what I often do when I'm on holiday, I just wander around and I don't think I want to go from A to B and guided tours as such. I just like to just wander about. There's a little Rose and Crown. Probably doing a good trade with a pub stay, Mother's Day. We'll just cross over here and have a look. It's the residential part. Lovely old Victorian properties as well. The London Welsh School. So it's a little bit of the residential areas of South Ealing. I'm going to walk back up onto the high street. There's a view of the church there. Lovely and quiet down here today. Looking at that shop front, they're restricted liquid. Try saying that after a few drinks. We should carry on. Got a bit fast on the pavement, he was. Took me by surprise, I could have knocked the camera out of my hand. And I've been knocking him off his bike. Not really, just joking. Green man, so we better nip across. Anyway, that's us at South Ealing station. A little 35 minute walk roundabouts. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed making it. I never realised how tiny the station was, but yeah, thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.